certainly don't want to speak for His Holiness, but just speaking for myself and speaking for the United States, I was very gratified by the meeting, and gratified as well by the strong leadership of His Holiness on the pandemic, on climate change, on the challenge that we have to address when it comes to irregular migration and refugees, and more broadly, and maybe most important of all, his leadership on the basic proposition that we have to stand for human dignity in everything we do to the best of our ability. We strongly support Italy's initiative to make sure that the coalition against Daesh focuses its expertise on Africa while keeping our eye closely on Syria and on Iraq. A special thank you to the heroes that we're celebrating today, women and men around the world who've dedicated their careers to stopping human trafficking. They're advocates, public servants, leaders of NGOs, and they help stop trafficking in all kinds of ways, by supporting victims, helping to bring traffickers to justice, creating national action plans, addressing the root causes of trafficking. In many ways, the fight against trafficking is fought on the local level, one community at a time. And we celebrate the brave people leading the fight, often at great risk to themselves. Trafficking in persons is an appalling crime. It's a global crisis. It's an enormous source of human suffering. This crime is an affront to human rights. It's an affront to human dignity. We fight it. You fight it because it's the right thing to do. It's also in our interest to stop trafficking. We know it's destabilizing to societies and to economies. So we must do everything we can as a country, but also as a global community, to stop trafficking wherever it occurs.
Earlier today, Secretary Blinken released the State Department's 2021 Trafficking in Persons Report, or the TIP Report, which examines government's efforts to combat human trafficking using a 3P framework of prosecuting traffickers, protecting victims, and preventing the crime. This report reflects the U.S. government's commitments to global leadership on this key human rights, law enforcement, and national security issue. It remains our principal diplomatic and diagnostic tool to guide our relations with foreign governments on human trafficking.
Doses have now all been shared with 46 countries, the African Union and CARICOM, through a combination of bilateral sharing and sharing through COVAX. Each country has received the specific number and type of U.S. vaccines they will be shipped, and by the end of this week, we will have already shipped out about 40 million doses to the Republic of Korea, Mexico, Canada, Brazil, Taiwan, Honduras, Colombia, Pakistan, Peru, Ecuador, Malaysia, and Bangladesh through a combination, again, of bilateral sharing and through COVAX as well. The remaining doses will be shipped in the coming weeks as countries complete their own domestic set of operational, regulatory, and legal processes. And we will continue to share even more doses in the summer months.